Okay, what's up guys, Alan here, back with another video. And today what we are going to do is not a tutorial video. I'm not going to just teach you some tricks or anything. Today I'm going to test out a great camera of Canon, that's the 5D Mark II. Yes, this is a very old camera, I know it. It's actually been like so many years after this camera has been released, but I'm getting it on my hands at these days, so I'm just going to try it out and really find out that is it really worth in this year to buy it. That's 2020. Is it really worth to buy this camera on this year? It is a full frame camera. It is actually capable of capturing very nice images. But other than that, now the camera is like Canon has released its new versions. The highest version of this camera is actually 5D Mark IV, and Sony is like pumping up by step, and everything is coming along. So that being said, let's start the video. So we are back in the studio, cause that place was like forest and there was like lot of sounds. Michael, it was a bird flapping over there, like so much of distraction. So just thought, let's make a video after getting back to the studio. So here I am. Now I'm gonna tell you what are my experience with a 12-year-old camera which I used 2 days before. So first of all, I would like to start with the build quality of this camera. This camera is actually so big and it is a pro camera, so you like getting a very big body. And as you know, I'm actually shooting every my videos in my A6000 series. Compared to the camera, it's like so big. I showed you in the video, like it is so big as my face.
And another thing which the 5D Mark II has, that it is having a second screen which displays all the information about the aperture, the shutter speed and the ISO. So this screen is actually very useful when you're just shooting out at night and you don't always need to look at the big screen to get the information about the photo. And it uses a compact disc with only one slot, and as it is a pro level camera, it is having all the ports like remote shutter, microphone, headphone jack, a USB port and HDMI port.
So let me just start with the advantages you get with buying this camera this year. So first and foremost, this camera is very affordable in the used market. Yeah, you will get this camera for like $250 to $500 in an affordable market like eBay or something. So it's like very cheap. And also, this is a full frame camera. That's like, since it's like this big and you can just do a lot of things, even though you have a camera which is like 12 years old but has a full frame camera. So it's very nice to have a full frame camera at like $250 or something. So it is very affordable in the used market. That's the first point which I want to mention, because it's a full frame camera and I love full frames and they are really expensive. If you want to buy a camera which is full frame, you need to actually spend $1,000 plus. But right now, as it is old and no one actually uses it, it is a good camera to buy and a full frame sensor. And the second greatest advantage is that this is a pro level camera, so it is giving that pro level kind of things, advantages like good build quality, and the buttons are all just super fine. Even though I'm using this camera after a long 12 years, still the camera feels like a camera. So third advantage, maybe it is having good battery life. It could shoot literally a full day and still left 15-20% battery. So that is the third advantage. And the next advantage would be like, it is having a really good image quality. After taking a photograph in that camera, you won't actually tell that it is a 12-year-old camera. That is its image quality. So as it is having a full frame sensor, it could take very good photographs. And for photographs, this camera is like still an awesome camera. If you compare it with the basic DSLR 2020 like Canon M50 or Sony A6000, the image quality is actually better than these cameras because of the reason that it has a full frame and it is a 5D Mark series. And the last advantage which I think to buy this camera is that it is a Canon camera. Yes, you would be thinking that is that an advantage or what? And I'm telling you yes, because the Canon has a wide range of collections of lenses and equipments, and these all lenses get compatible with this camera. So when you just buy a normal budget friendly camera like Canon 50 or Canon 200D, Canon like smaller budget cameras, they actually are not compatible with full frame lenses. But this camera, which is just $250 or something, are compatible with those lenses. And the Canon guys have like very big collection of lenses, so all of those lenses will be compatible with this camera. And that I think is the second most biggest advantage of buying this camera. That I think is the second biggest reason why you should be consider buying Canon 5D Mark II this year. So guys, now let's move to the cons of buying this camera. That is the disadvantages of buying this camera. So the first one would be, it has only 9 points of autofocus. Yes, it has only 9 points of autofocus and it is right on the center. So it is like actually a kind of hard to autofocus fast moving objects or something, because those autofocus point doesn't like moves to the edges, it just stays in the center. So that's one of the disadvantages. So the main thing which I think that only 9 autofocus point is not enough for a camera is that the camera which I'm shooting right now is a Sony A6000 series. It was launched a few years back and this camera actually is having 176 autofocus points. Yes, and that camera is having only 9 autofocus points. So that's the reason which I think that it is one of the cons of this camera, because of the only 9 autofocus points. And it would not be ideal for shooting sports or like fast moving objects because the autofocus is right in the center. So those were all the reasons which forces you to buy this camera, or don't buy this camera, or never consider it, never mind. But still, I think that this camera is a really capable camera, because the photos which comes out of this camera is like pure gold. I could easily guarantee you that you could just take great quality of photos from this camera itself.
So that's it guys, these were the reasons through which I think that I could recommend you this camera to buy in this year. Like, share, dislike if you didn't like the video, and comment down below if you have any other queries about this camera, and do subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. So with that being said, I'll talk to you guys in the next one.